Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to my blog. Hey, let's talk about entities. What are they and how to get rid of them? Okay? All right. Entities? What the fuck are you talking about, entities? What the... Here's the deal. Here's the deal about these things. humanity has a little issue here, a little problem. And the problem is there are beings or entities that are out to control, dominate, and suppress humanity, right? And some of these are incorporeal, and some of them are corporeal. Some of them are incarnate, and some of them are discarnate. In other words, some of these bad boys are in physical bodies, and some are not. And it's bad enough when you have evil are mean, malevolent beings in bodies. That's bad enough. But the problem is worse because there are these beings or entities that are incorporeal, yet they can mess with us psychically and mentally and emotionally. Now, for some people, this is all old news, right? But for some people, this is brand new. So, you know, I'm kind of undercutting the explanation here. One of the reasons I want to bring it up is because because a lot of people have entity issues, and because this morning I did a technique for getting rid of some dark entities, and I go, you know, it works so well, I want to share the technique with you, right? I want to share how to do it, or what you can do if you've got entity issues. But I wanted to tell you a little bit more about the whole subject of entities first. And you notice how my throat's a little tight? This is probably entity stuff. The thing about entities are that they can mess with us in really subtle, devious ways. And it's the psychological or mental and emotional ways. Because these things can actually get into your space without you being aware of them. And they can generate an emotional response or a feeling state. They can generate stress, anger, hate, fear, sadness, lust, anything really. And we will think it's our own emotional response. And we start looking at why do we feel the way we feel. And it's simply one kind of entity or another messing with you for one reason or another. Okay? Through all this, the good news, to cut this short, if you're like done, you don't want to watch this whole video. The short news is that I did a soul contract revocation session on the subject. It was just my issue looking at negative stuff, you know. But the process is so powerful that it digs deep within the subconscious mind, finds agreements that we have made with entities, or we've made agreements about ourselves, and it requires an entity, it requires an assistant to help us manifest this thing we've agreed to create and manifest as part of our life. So I was looking at negative stuff, and you know, it's like I'm compulsive, you know, it's like, you know, it's looking at the New World Order negative stuff, right? You know, all the bad things that are going on the planet. For one, chemtrails, fluoride in the water, mercury in flu shots, and people pushing flu shots, and just genetically modified food. And it's endless, the negative stuff going on the planet, right? So I feel it's very important to know this stuff. But I've been too into it, too much focused on the negative and not enough on the positive. And I've been feeling like shit for a few weeks. I go, at the time, I didn't have any idea why I was feeling the way I was feeling. But today I finally decided to do a session on focusing too much on the negative and actually looking for negative stuff. And not just in the world, but, you know, my emotional stuff and my relationships and financial stuff and health stuff. And, you know, I'm trying to go fruitarian or at least vegetarian. Coffeetarian. Addictions to coffee. Anyway, too much negative, right? So I finally did this session today. And it starts out as a regular soul contract revocation session. But I pulled up the agreements. I agree that I focus on the negative. I agree that I want to know what's going on. See, the agreeing to know what's going on, that sounds like a solid, rock solid, good, wholesome, healthy agreement. And it'll work for you. Well, sure, it's okay to know what's going on. But if you're signing a contract with something or somebody or some group, or your organization, or your religion, or your society, you've agreed you made these agreements to be a citizen of your country, and so you will abide by the rules, even if you don't know all the rules. You agree, blah blah blah. Yeah, I'm a law abiding citizen. I agree to follow the laws. Okay, don't throw me in jail. Okay, so we make all these agreements, and we live by those. And if we break those rules that we've agreed to live by, then we feel we get some punitive damages here. We'll get punished. We will get reprimanded. Bad things will happen to us. Or on an emotional level, we'll feel bad, wrong, guilty, because we've agreed to an emotional response. Some people, if they they come up and scare a dog because they think it's cute, they go boo, and they scare the little puppy that's just, you know, laying there sleeping, and they laugh and they think it's funny. Their agreements deep down are that, hey, it would be funny to scare the shit out of something. Watch, and they scare the fuck out of something, and then they laugh. It's their agreements. Whether they're soul contract level agreements or just what they've agreed in this life or some lifetime, many lifetimes ago, it doesn't matter. We've made our agreements and we live by them. Even our emotional responses. Some people, they can't get mad. They can't get angry. They, if you ask them, well, is getting angry then a bad idea? Yeah, it's not good to get angry. Oh, so you would agree that it's not good to get angry? Yeah, I agree it's not good to get angry. Okay. Well, what might happen if you get angry? Well, if I get angry, I might say something I would regret. Or I might do something I would regret. I have to hold my anger in. And I would just, you know, I could ask them, oh, so you agree that you have to hold your anger in? Oh, yeah. See, a person doesn't see their agreements as agreements until you kind of ask them about it. Or if you're digging for your own agreements, if you're doing a soul contract revocation session, you look at your own and you ask yourself, well, do I agree that it's bad to get angry? Yeah. Okay. But you've made your notes and you look at your other notes and you go, I probably shouldn't get angry then, right? You agree that you probably shouldn't get angry? Oh, yeah. So what you're doing is you're bringing up your stuff. You're telling your story about your life, and you're seeing what it is you've agreed to. You know, I've agreed to my reality, and that's what life is. Your life is your reality. Your reality is real to you because you agree that it is real and that it is your reality. You talk to one guy and says, do you believe you in UFOs? Yeah, they're out there, man. So you agree that they're out? Yeah, they're out there. You ask somebody else, you agree, you believe in UFOs? Nah, that's bullshit. Oh, you would agree that UFOs and ETs, that's all bullshit, no such thing? Yeah, totally. See how easy and quickly a person will recognize an agreement when you approach the subject in that way. See, so these agreements, they work on such a deep and profound level that when you do a soul contract revocation session and you pull that stuff up and you pull them up on all timelines in the past, present, the future, other dimensions, planes, densities, you just pull all that shit up on one particular subject, you go, and you make notes, man. I teach you how to do take notes, motherfucker. And you go, oh, shit, I got a lot of shit here. Oh, my God. And then you go through your notes and you check it out. Oh, yeah. Oh, fuck. And then there's other steps, stages that you want to revoke and cancel reinstatement clauses. That's a little clause in agreement or a contract that if you cancel the agreement, the other party has the right to reinstate the agreement. So we got these in a psychological, subconscious level, too. All kinds of tricky shit. So if you've ever tried to do a soul contract revocation session to get rid of some agreements, to get rid of, to change your life, and it didn't fucking work, it's probably because you didn't get all the agreements, or you missed some of the revocations or the copies or duplicates or backups that you didn't quite pick off. So I can show you how to do that, too. But what's this got to do with entities? Well, aside from agreeing with yourself, there's other aspects of yourself which are kind of like other entities within self. You know, you've got your light side and your dark side. And that aspect of self being that identity, when you're in that identity, it's it's an entity, but that's with self. Okay, so we're kind of okay if we're agreeing with ourselves, okay? But when we start agreeing with other beings, other people, whether they're in the astral plane, the between lives area, by some other name, or these entities that... They're everywhere, man. They're everywhere. Am I getting red? Let's see how red I'm getting. I'm getting embarrassed because I'm falling off the track here. Entities made me do it. Yeah. Okay, let me regroup here for a minute. Okay. When you have an issue, okay, not only is it most likely that you've agreed to have this kind of issue, like we're talking about bigger issues in our lives, right? You're not lucky in love. You're not lucky in finances. You're a loser. You're a, you know, you're a, it's just issue after issue. Doesn't matter. There's just tons of them. The theory is that we've agreed to all of our issues and our strengths, weaknesses and strengths, before we incarnated, okay? It's kind of like we agree to the terms of service before we start playing the virtual reality game. Microsoft comes up with a virtual reality game. Oh, do you want to play? Yeah, I want to play. Sounds like fun. Well, agree to this shit. And you don't want to read the whole motherfucker. You go, fine, click, I agree. Now you're bound by that, legally bound by that. And so now you're into the virtual reality game. You put on your glasses. We don't put on glasses, we put on the whole body. We get born into the body. Yay, now we can play. And we might know some of the agreements, the key agreements, when we came in, we negotiated those. You know, do I got to do that? I got to be this way? I got to do that? Eh. Well, I want to do this. So I want to do this game experience. I want to do this experience in physical reality. So, okay, I agree. And so you agree to all this shit. And I mean this like page after page. Now, that can be metaphorically speaking or it can be literal. You know, it's however you experience it, feel it, see it, know it, believe it. When you consider your agreements on different subjects, in your sole contract agreements on different subjects. But the point is, you made the agreements, and now that you're here, you don't know specifically what you've agreed to, just like you don't know what you specifically agreed to when you agreed to download and install and play the latest version of Skyrim or Assassin's Creed or Uncharted 4, 5, 6, whatever. And you play the game. So here we are. We're in this game. Now, when you do how you get rid of entities. Well, let me back up. You've made these agreements with these other entities. We can call them Lords of Karma, Ascended Masters, Gatekeepers, just beings. Whatever you give them, doesn't matter what you call them, but you made agreements with beings who are sort of standing there. You want to come in and play on physical Earth? Talk to me. Okay. Now, do you agree to this, that, and the other? Mm-hmm. Okay. Now you can go. Yay. And so then you get incarnated. So that's one kind of entity. So you can release agreements with these kinds of entities. But here's the thing that people don't really know, and I should have mentioned this a long time ago, but these lesser entities can get in your space because of agreements you've made. So you make some agreements about... You get angry easily. Let's just say that's one of them. Or you cry easily, or you're easily scared. Doesn't matter. But you've made an agreement about an emotional response. And now you get this emotional response a lot. Let's say you get angry real easy. It's like you can't handle your anger very well. Anger issues. Well, you make the greater agreement or the greater issue. The greater soul contract agreement before coming here with these gatekeeper type entities. Okay. But now while you're here, because you've agreed to get angry easily, you might attract another kind of entity, a lesser entity, whose job it is to help you feel and experience anger easily. Does that make sense? I feel like I'm fucking rambling today. This started out like such a great... Put on my tie, I'm all ready to go, I'm going to make a great video. And the motherfucker's rambling. But what did happen today, this morning I did a session on myself in bed before I got up. Once you learn how to do the soul contract stuff, you can do it. Well, it took about 30, 45 minutes, but you know all the steps, and you can do it in your head. You don't have to sit down with a recorder or a typewriter or a typewriter or a keyboard or anything. You can just do it. And what happened was I picked off the agreements that I made to be certain ways that I made that would cause me to behave in certain ways that I didn't like, and caused me to feel certain things in certain situations that I didn't like. And when I revoked those contracts, those basic agreements on that level, it leaves nothing for these lesser entities to attach to. The agreement is canceled. It's like agreeing with some cleaning service, some guy downtown in his office to have a crew come in and clean your house and your driveway and rake the leaves and all this other shit. And then that gives this guy you don't even fucking know coming in, now he's in your backyard raking your fucking, hey, who are you? Oh, I'm with the company. Oh, okay. And let's say you don't like what these guys are doing because they're not, they're really cleaning your house. They're cleaning you out. And you go, whoa, this is messed up. And you look at the fine print and it says, yeah, every time they come over to clean something, they can take something. I didn't agree to this. Yes, you did. You signed a contract. Well, I didn't see that. Too bad. You got conned. You got deceived. You got hustled. You see. So it's kind of like that. So when you make an agreement with headquarters, it allows the crew to come into your space, into your house, and do that thing they do that you've agreed to, and you didn't even know you agreed to do it, or allow them to do that. So when you revoke the agreement on a basic level, like you're able to, you know, you go back over to headquarters, hey, this is an illegal contract. This was deception. This was, you deceived me. You lied. Fraud. So you have every right to revoke the contract. Cancel it. I cancel this contract. But if you don't know it's a, you've been conned, you don't know that you've even agreed to these lesser things within a big contract, and the whole thing was a deceptive con. If you didn't know that, you can't revoke it. And so you're still allowing these guys to come over and do that thing, and they're cleaning your house, and they're taking your shit, and they're messing with you and those you love and all this. So so it is with entities. These lesser entities will get into your space. And they will be the emotional response. They will be a negative thought. They will be a compulsion. These lesser entities, they feel like thoughts. They're a thought in your head. They're feeling, they're sensation in your body. This is deep spiritual shit, and I should be giving it great, you know, respect. And oh, this is just deep shit, man. Oh, really, man? This is serious shit. But yeah. And it's been going on forever on this planet. And the people that know what they're doing, they know how to remove these entities. They know how to, they can see them, sense them one way or another. And then there's dark forces and beings that are dark. And they use these techniques and all these principles to black magic shit. And they cast spells using entities. They will take an entity, program the entity like a little, you will go walk with me. Then they literally just beam the little fucker off to somebody, and that entity will go to somebody. But that somebody that this entity goes to fuck with, somebody had to have an agreement in place to be the effect of this kind of psychic attack in the first place. This guy, this being, this person. So it's possible for this person to look at their own shit, not so much worry about the being that attacked them or the entity that this being used to attack with, but look at their own stuff and the agreements that this being has made with this being, the agreements that this being has made with this little bitty entity being, and the agreements that this being has made to experience the emotional response or the psychological thing, the thought response that this being here, this person, has agreed to experience, that is causing them to experience this reality. You see how that works? It's deep shit, man. So anyway, I did a session this morning, and it just... It's been a while since I did a soul contract session on myself. And I'm feeling like shit. So anyway, I did one. And it tapped into a real dark entity that was right in my space. And I thought it was me feeling like shit. I thought it was me just feeling crappy and a little confused, worried, concerned, frustrated, this kind of stuff. I thought it was me. I thought it was my thoughts and my feelings. I did this session. I got the core contracts on this timeline, other timelines, in the past, present, and future, in this universe, this reality, and other universes, realities, dimensions, planes. You know, you just like scour it, man. You just look for all these agreements in all kinds of tricky secret places, right? So anyway, I pull them all up, and you don't have to be aware of each one specifically. You just like, oh, I get it, yeah. And then you can do the revocation technique processes on the agreements that you've pulled up. And I blew out a basic agreement that allowed this dark entity to blend with my energy. And I thought it was me. And they love that shit. It's like a fucking parasite that gets in your space and just sucks you dry. Fuck. So when that blew out, it felt really good. I go, wow, that's pretty fucking cool. I should tell some people about this. So here I am, yapping it up. Another reason I wanted to share this stuff with you is recently people have been writing in and asking me about entity stuff. One student, or one person that watches my YouTube channel, they're being psychically attacked by some lady who knew black magic, voodoo stuff. And some of those people that know that sort of subject know how to use this entity thing to their advantage, to the dismay of the rest of us. So yeah, this entity subject is really a big subject, and I'm just barely scratching the surface here, yapping it up like this about the subject. But I wanted to kind of give it a, you know, kind of a street level, hey, check it out. This is not like a major dissertation on the subject. But there are quite a few schools of thought that are very keen on the subject. Okay. So I wanted to share this with you. And said, you know, there's entities and there's a way to handle them. There's other entity handling techniques too, by the way. There's one where you ask for help from great, powerful beings, specifically for the reptilian entity. And that's pretty effective. I teach that technique too on richwest.net, Entity Removal Bootcamp. If you do Entity Removal Bootcamp, you get Soul Contract Bootcamp too. If you do buy the Soul Contract Revocation Bootcamp, you get the Entity Bootcamp too if you need or want it. You know, I'm supposed to feel guilty selling shit, right? People say, hey, you, there he is, I knew it! Selling shit, I knew it! Well, the first entity course I paid for, the entity removal course, was cost over $1,000. Mine's under 100. It works better too. Mine's a do-it-yourself thing. There's people out there that, you know, that's what their service. You know, they will help you spot your entities and help you release them. So there's that too. Now there's a whole nother subject about entities that I want to talk about, but I think I'm going to put it in a different video. It's about the relationship between entities, because they're non-corporeal. They're they're not of this dimension or density. They're not of physical reality. We can't see them, touch them. We can sense and, well, some people can see and touch and feel them. Yeah, but they usually have their third eye thing going really well. But they're in a different plane or realm. Lower astral, it's called sometimes. Fourth density reality. There's just levels, multiple levels of vibrational frequency levels that these dark fuckers hang out in. And I want to talk more about that. And the greater reality. The greater reality being a place more real than this, more pleasant to live in, has all the adventure and the fun and everything you'd ever want in a great paradise world. But it's not a religious heaven world. It's not any of that. It's just another reality system. And it makes this one look like the fake. This being the simulation of a greater, better reality. This is like a very poor copy. A knockoff used to ensnare beings, making this a matrix, like in the movie. So anyway, I want to talk more about that in a different video. You know. So yeah. Oh, and one last thing. People have been writing in and sharing their entity issues. You know, it's not every day you hear people talking about entity issues, but because of what I do and what I teach, people write to me. And recently another fella had a vivid dream of literally being asked to this dark being. I'm sure I'm not mentioning his name. I'm sure he won't mind me relating his story, broad strokes, generalize the story. He encounters this being, and the being says, "Hey, let me help you." No, it's okay. I'm good. No, you know, there's some things going on, and I could really be of assistance to you. Look, why don't you? If you just sign this a contract here, then I'll be able to help you because, you know, you're in danger. Oh, no, I don't think so. And this person, being, entity, kept insisting that this guy that wrote to me sign this contract, this agreement. And, you know, this viewer was wise to this shit. You go, no, no. And this thing kept insisting. Finally, it was scare tactics. You know, well, you know, you're going to need some help, and I'm the one to help you, because if you don't, see that thug over there? He's you're going to get attacked. He's going to come after you. And you look over, and there's this eagle thug-looking fucking entity thing over there. What the fuck is that? And so this being trying to get this guy to sign the contract, he's going. And this is in a lucid dream, right? This is between lives. This is what's happening in the sleep state for this person. Trying to get him to sign a contract, an agreement. And he wasn't a student of mine. He was asking about the soul contract revocation stuff, but he wasn't a student. And he says the next level of threat was it was fucking blackmail. If you don't sign this contract, I'm not going to help you, and that thing is going to attack you. I pissed this guy off, the viewer, and finally he just tacked the motherfucker. Just, fuck you, motherfucker, the fuck out of here. Something like that. I may be exaggerating, but yeah. I love to hear about this sort of thing because I believe a lot of people are being fucked with in their sleep state. I believe everybody dreams or has lucid dreams or has out-of-body experiences. In other words, consciousness shifts into other planes, densities, realms, dreamscapes, reality systems. Every night, we're doing something like that. Some people, their body falls, they fall asleep spiritually, and their body falls asleep, and the being is basically out cold. And when he is in his dream state or lucid dream or out-of-body experience, he's a walking freaking zombie just about. He doesn't remember anything. It's like being drugged. Let's say if you went out one night, Saturday night, and somebody put a roofie in your drink, and you're like, you're walking around, you're doing things. You're sort of half conscious at the time. You're still walking and you're having conversations. But you wake up in the morning and you don't remember Jack. It's all, what? What happened? I did what with who? Really? You got pictures? Oh, no. It's like that when we spiritually go to sleep at night. We need to wake up. But most of humanity isn't all that wide awake when their physical body's asleep. Oh, shut up. Did you see? That's, shut up. Jesus, it's probably going to ring again, too. I'm not going to write. Shut up. So anyway, these entities, people write to me about them. One time a lady, she woke up in the middle of the night and this big reptilian thing was right in her bedroom and just jumped at her, grabbed her by the throat and everything. Oh, I was talking about when we fall asleep at night, do whatever you can to stay awake spiritually while your body's sleeping. And the more you can be awake and stay awake, the more likely you are to remember your dream, lucid dream, or out-of-body experience, or consciousness shift, phase shift, quantum jump, whatever you want to call it. So, and the reason that's a good idea, aside from all the wonderful experiences and how you can learn what the greater reality is really like, besides that, you are more aware of what the dark forces or entities are doing, messing with you at night while the body sleeps. You wake up in the morning and you go, what just happened? You know this thing about night terrors, not to mention nightmares, but these night terrors, you know, it's mostly with kids. They'll be screaming and scared shitless in their sleep, and they wake up and they don't remember a thing. Real creepy, freaky. Well, I've done research and given sessions to people where they're able to go back into their dream state and see and remember what they didn't see or remember. And yeah, sure enough, these thug entities of one kind or another, and some of them look like, you know, your basic demon in a computer game or a novel or a movie. Some of them look like big thug, troll-looking things. Some of the little bitty things. They're just, and they can shapeshift. And then some of them look like the reptilians. You know, they're humanoid, but they got the reptilian feature set going. There's just all kinds. It's a weird subject. It's a creepy subject, but it's an important subject when you're ready for it. It's important to know about so that you can deal with the subject, deal with the entities. There's ways to communicate with them, communicate to them. You can give them sessions. You can be nice to them. You can be tough, tough love. You can just be, you know, righteously pissed. And there's ways to deal with these entities. And one of the best ways is to find the agreements that you've made relative to the entity and the entity issue that you've got going. And this can break the entity free of you, that bond you have, and it's agreement, it's contract, it's an agreement sort of thing. And they go. So it's good to know, good shit to know. I do want to say that there's all kinds of entity issues that people have. Most people, it's not real bad. It's more of an emotional thing, or they got going, or repetitive emotional or psychological thing they got, or a condition in their life. It's not so bad. But some people have serious entity issues. And this soul contract revocation thing helps a little, but doesn't work. It does. Now, I don't know if it's the technique or the person applying the technique, but nah. This isn't the one-shot fix for all entity issues by no stretch. I met some people have written to me, and they have some serious, serious entity shit. They need more than a soul contract revocation session or two, that's for sure. I'm just glad that's not me. I don't have that kind of shit going. Whew. That's some serious shit, man. Okay. You know, they're hearing the voices and they're seeing the things and they're just, you know, they're going to, it takes control of their body and all kinds of fucking crap. Yeah, it's heavy duty. I think there's ways to deal with them, but, you know, I don't have all the tools and all the techniques for that kind of serious, some of those serious, serious things. But yeah, just saying. Okay. Thank you for watching and listening. And if you got entity things going on, share them in comments. You know, the more you share your shit, and people go, hey, I thought it was just me. And then other people share their shit, we get a better understanding of what's going on in the beyond the veil, how they're dealing, how they're fucking with us and all kinds of things. And again, like I said, I just barely touched the surface of this whole subject. And it wasn't an organized teaching thing. It was just me yapping about it. But good to know. It's good stuff to know. So that you'll have some tools and resources and ways to expunge or clear out or release yourself from these entities and the agreements you may have made that allow them in your space. Okay? Thanks for watching. For more information on this thing, you can check out richwest.net. Okay? All right. Take care of yourself. Share your stories. Love to hear them. Dreams, lucid dreams, out-of-body experiences, encounters with ETs, reptilians, greys, all kinds of shit. Okay. It just kind of helps us all get a better understanding of it, I think. Okay. I'll talk to you later.